Hi, this is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. We get a lot of different types of dogs on our property for our board and train. We get a lot of dogs with aggression problems, and I want you to know it doesn't make a difference the size of the dog. Here's a little dog, a 7-pound dog named Pickles that came to us with some dog-dog aggression, antisocial behavior, zero obedience command, would run away from their owner, never come back, did not know sit, did not know down, knew some tricks, some cool little party tricks, but no obedience commands, barked out of control at everything, which is a adrenaline level issue. It's not cute. I'm sorry, barking dogs are not cute. They're actually quite annoying. So let me just show you, we're gonna run Pickles just through some commands. No remote collars, no prong collars, totally off leash, and let's just see how it goes. All right, come on in. We've got Pickles in our small dog room. All dogs, when we open up the crate, are supposed to wait. Pickles, here. And let's bring her over. Pickles, here. Good. Place. Nope. A little bit distracted by the camera woman over there. The thing about the place command, as we know from my other videos, the place command is a great command for household management. When the dog is in place, your dog is what? Not jumping at kids, not lunging at strangers, not jumping on furniture. Pickles, here. Good. Pick. Sit. Down. All right. Look at you, superstar. Okay. And place. That's so wonderful. Now, one of the things that's important is we have lots of different distractions. Okay, this is not teasing the dog. This is distracting the dog. I want to make sure that my dog, and you know, of course, every house has one of these. I want to make sure my dog, anything moving, the dog doesn't run under. When I touch the dog with it, it doesn't hurt. This is that caution tape that's about half the weight of a plastic bag. Pickles, here. Good, sit. Down. There you go. Good girl. Look at you, superstar. Okay. And let's come over here and let's do a place. And place right there. Why? Because when somebody's coming opening up the door, that's where the camera should probably be, so the camera can actually see what we're doing. You know, it's not just some sound machine that's actually working. Hey, come on. Pickles, here. Good. Pick. Sit. Down. Good. Nope. Nope. Again, when I say no, that's a correction, and the dog goes back into the command. So, it's important that the dog understands what no means. I'm a firm believer of saying no to my children and no to my dogs. And we say no when the dog breaks command, and you saw Pickles go right back down into a downstay. We don't have to repeat the command. Good job, Pickles. Let's go, Pickles. Place. Good. Good job. Pickles, here. Place. Good job, Pick. Good job, Pickles. Pickles, here. Nope, here. Good, Pick. Sit. Down. All right, look at you. A little basic command. Now let's put her back in her kennel up, okay? Come on, Pick, let's go. And get back in your kennel. Kennel up. Good, there you go. Good. It's so important, whether you have a 7-pound dog or a 107-pound dog, that you've got control of your dog, that your dog listens to you. Now, I'll show you what we do with these dogs that are board and trained over and over and over again. There's no secret to what we do other than repetition. But when I say sit, I want the dog to sit. When I say down, I want the dog to down. Now, you'll hear a lot of different things about balanced training based on corrections. Well, guess what? That's how I train Pickles. All right, Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. Thank you so much for watching.
Good. Sit. Down. Okay. Are you recording?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Pickles, place. Nope. Pick. There you go. Look at you, superstar. There you go. Good. Pickles, here. Good. Sit. Down. Nope. There you go. Nope. Okay. Place. There you go, Pick. Good job. Look at you. No one's being a superstar. Yeah, look at you. A little superstar. A little shorty there.
Pickles, here. Good. Good girl. Over here, Pickles. Good.